Toad.
Toad.
Harry, I have nothing.
Yeah, I told you it was a hard one.
I'm Maria Tutaia and welcome to another episode of Fresh. Now, if you grew up around broken English, avoiding flying jandals and wondering if you were ever going to be allowed to date, then makua sekia, this show is definitely for you.
Moving from graffiti influence with Tutau, he's breaking new grounds there.
First of all, we need one of these Johnny's knife.
Now, the one great thing I love about living here in New Zealand are the great events that take part here all year round. And this week's Brown and Around is no exception.
Right now we're in the heart of Mangere in Manukau City, and we're in the middle of the Rage 2011, Cook Islands mini music festival.
Go the Rage 2011!
I came all the way from Australia for this event.
We're just here to support not only the international acts, but also the local ones as well, eh?
Our music festival is a chance for us to show our pride and our culture. Over the past few years, it seemed to have dimmed off when we're talking about language. This is one of the ways that we can strengthen our ties with the homeland.
The name of the group is the Poriru's main event.
We are from the Te Atamera Cook Islands Cultural Dance Group, and we're from Brisbane, Australia.
We are the Te Ari Pai Pai Multicultural Group.
Cabin Red Boys!
Come on, we like you just don't care, cause KBV in the house, everybody say yeah! Hey yeah!
Normally the Rage is a snapshot of today. This one we've decided to take a snapshot of some of the great names of the past.
Oh, it's wonderful, wonderful, performing with my daughter.
It truly reminds us of where we're from.
This is like the Justin Bieber of his time, people.
I think it's a great opportunity for us as Cook Islanders to share our music, share our culture, and let the rest of the world enjoy what we have to offer.
A lot of Cook Island culture going on tonight. Good band. It's just been a fabulous night tonight.
I think that this is fresh because all the islands come together and we all rage it together as one.
Oh, I felt tonight was so awesome. Must get your ticket next year. 2012 Rage all day.
Namaste and Pak Choi. Welcome back. You know who I am, it's your favorite. Uncle Rara. That's my name. That's my name. Forget about that. You know where I'm from, The Rock. Finally, The Rock has come back to. I don't care where you're from, just make sure you're from Niue, The Rock of Polynesia. You know, today on IFOP, I bring to you something that not hipster people have, only some people. It's called a Bluetooth application. Bluetooth application? Bluetooth application! Blip blip! Come on, follow me, let's go! Get away from me, please. That dog's gonna get it. Hey, how many times you wake up in the morning and there's no more bread in the kitchen? All you do is get your mobile phone and you go on internet and you download a picture of a bread. Just like that, yeah, and then all you do is Bluetooth the application to the toaster. One, two! How many times you go to the dairy and you don't have enough money? Don't worry, always remember to carry the BT devices with you so you can ask them, please, can you put it on my BT account?
Oh, sure, absolutely. Anything, Ankara.
Yeah, then you put the costing in the phone and then you send the Bluetooth to the FBOs. 1, 2.
Declined.
Let's do that again. 1, 2.
Acceptable.
Yeah, good girl, my son. Yeah, let's go. Hey, how many of you been in this similar situation? Doors locked, keys in the house. Easy! All you do is pull out your mobile phone and you pull it to the door. Remember, when you open the Bluetooth application, it's gonna open the door. 1, 2. Easy! Yeah, so remember, see you next week. Good girl, my son.
Press record. Hustle now, do your thing, thing. Do your thing, thing. Hustle now, do your thing, thing. Do your thing, thing. Hustle now, do your thing, thing. Hustle now,
Why you say? Now let me.
Two.
Says.
Chooses. I'm feeling a little bit parched.
Do you want some of my juices?
Okay, thank you.
I remember the very first time I played for the Silver Ferns. Man, it was like White Sunday all over again. Sweaty palms, missed a few crucial shots, I was really nervous. But hey, once you hit the big stage, you've got to step up.
Talofa, Juice One here, Wanderers Triple S crew. Just here in Hamilton, we're at the International Tattoo and Art Expo. Gonna check out some fat ink on the peoples out there. Also gonna get busy with the spray cans and jam out a wall today. Later on, I'm gonna take you from the wall to the skin. Follow me.
Along with strong letter structure, which is first and foremost important in graffiti writing, you gotta have some fat letters, you gotta bring that funk and that style. I was really aiming to combine hip hop and being Samoan and proud of it. So it's what I like to do with my pieces. I always make them alive, lots of energy, lots of color, kind of like Islanders, really. I also added in the character, as an island woman, had elements of the Malu tattooed onto it, and I sort of gave it just the island theme, nice sunset, a couple of fales and some coconut trees, and my letter S kind of just noticing it with a little fresh comment there.
Talo for lover, my name's Andy Taufiafi, I'm from Taupo to Tau. Juice One, up and coming tattoo artist, starting from graffiti art, now he's moving into the Tatau scene. He's got the basic foundations, the rest is up to Juice One. The skills that you need to be a Tatau artist, it's on a smaller scale, so time is key. You gotta have a lot of patience because there ain't no rubber to rub this out. Once you make the mark, you're marked for life. Moving from graffiti influence with Tatau, he's breaking new grounds there, and I'm sure Juice One is going to break some new grounds in the Tatau scene. Juice One.
Kia ora talofa, my name's Joran Adrian Tuitama. I was fortunate enough to meet Juice at a hip-hop gig, and I seen him do his graph work. I was just blown away, and I heard he was doing tats as well, so I was like, had this idea, like I wanted to get my family name and graph on myself, and yeah, pretty much just asked him, and he said yes.
I saw it as a natural progression from the spray cans to the tech guns, really, because there's a lot of similarities between the two cultures and between the two aesthetics, in a way. The challenges between going from the can to the gun, well, there's a few. Mainly is, yeah, it's permanent, you know. Every line you make with a tattoo gun counts, and there's really no going back, so you really have to put a lot of thought into what you're doing and when you're doing it. And also, the swap of energy that you have when you're doing a tattoo, you know, like I said, it's a living person, you're sharing that experience with them, so it's not only the artwork that you gotta put out there, but it's also just the whole experience from start to finish that you share with that person.
Tuitama, it means a lot to me. It's, you know, it's who I am, it's my family name, it's what I'll pass down to my children, and I'm really proud of my family. So I got a basketball on there, It pretty much represents myself and my whole family. We're a basketball family. Yeah, Tuitama, hard.
Stomping ground, Mount Albert. Most people used to say I used to run this street, but Mount Albert Grammar, which is just down the road, Linfield College, Block of Spain Intermediate, and Chaucer Primary, which are all I used to go to. But I must admit, I am actually not from Auckland. My roots are in Samoa. And a wise man once told me, if you don't know where you're from, you never know where you're going. Oh, love your box, eh?
Know your roots! This week is the death of Tutunui. Sounds cool, eh? No? Sweet as. Tutunui was the pet whale of Tingilau. Now Tingilau was kind of a fish whisperer. Why he had a pet whale, I suppose, eh? Now Tingilau had set a date to marry his true love Hina, or Thina if you have a lisp. He sent a request to the high priest Guy of the Broken Teeth. Not a nice name, I know, but it was true. His teeth was broken. Guy agreed to do Tingilau and Sina's wedding. It was the bomb. After the festivities, it was time for Guy to return to his island. He asked Tingilau if he could catch a ride home on Tutunui the whale because he had no sober driver. Tingilau agreed, but he warned Guy that if he reached the shores, Tutunui will shake, which is your signal to get off and swim to the shore. Otherwise, the whale will be torn apart on the sharp, rocky shore. Guy said, sweet ass brother, and they were off. When they neared Guy's shores, Tutunui gave the signal for Guy to jump off and swim to shore. But oh my crazies, you know, Guy stayed on the whale after Tingilau warned him. Tutunui was torn apart on the rocks. Guy and his people then cooked and ate the whale. Yum, I mean, sad. Back on the other side of the great Te Moana Nui Akiwa, that's the Pacific Ocean. Tingilau waited for his beloved pet to return, but no return. Galofai. After a few days, Tingilau became sus. He could smell the aroma of the cooked whale flesh from across the ocean, and Tingilau grieved for his dead pet. Then he got angry and plotted revenge. Tingilau turned Hamlet and hired some of his undercover entertainers to go to Guy's island and put on a show for his village. Some of his friends included Enrique Iglesias, Michael Chitson, and Christina Aguilera. Everyone loved it and they laughed so hard they fell asleep. This was part of Tingilau's plan. Tingilau had told them to look for the man with the worst teeth they had ever seen. Wait till he falls asleep, then bring him back to me. Everything went to plan, and Guy laughed so hard the entertainers had no trouble recognizing him. When Guy woke up in Tingilau's whale, he realized his hangover was the least of his worries. Just goes to show, kids, always brush your teeth, otherwise the tooth fairy will not come to you because you got a smelly breathe. Know Your Roots reserves the right to make most of this up, so if you want to know more about it, go see a dentist.
I love the new songs these days, but you still gotta love the old gems. Old gems, eh? This guy was...
This is a rock we sing time every night.
Don't go too far. When we get back, more freshness. Hey, I'm Maria Tutaia, and this is my world. Off your mic.
Pow!
Dirt!
Powder! Hey, don't worry, forget about it!
Hey, I'm Maria Tutaia, and this is my world. Off your mic. Welcome, this is my home out here in West Auckland. I live here with my parents. My mum and dad, my sister and her partner and the kids. We've got another special unit down. Special unit for special needs. I started playing netball when I was about 7 or 8 years old. I was at Chaucer Primary School in Blackhouse Bay. I was in like the F team. We pretty much lose every game. I loved to chuck a ball around. I played quite a lot of sports when I was at school, a lot of rugby, soccer, touch.
Skaili fai tamboi, tamboi. O ngā lava 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 e fai te mi o a onga. E fai o ngā lava le ofu vai e te ua fai tama.
Being a Samoan has helped me with every aspect of who I am and what I'm about in my game. Just the determination that most of us islanders have. I want to give the old fuki slam every now and then. I was thinking I should carry a jandal under one of my dresses just to bust out the jandal chop or something. Outside of netball, I went down the fashion path a few years ago, so I'm wanting to go back and finish that, and I'd love to design shoes. A lot of netballers, we have long or wide gullo feet. You know, here's the shoe and here are my feet. In this very moment, I'm king. In this very moment, I slay Goliath with a sling. Mum and Dad have always inspired all of us kids to strive for whatever we want, and that, yes, dreams are for free, but they're achievable. I've got a brother in Scotland who we keep in contact with quite a bit with rugby, and I've got another brother in Whangarei. We see each other a lot every Sundays for Kōrae after church. Mum and Dad have always made sure that no matter where we are around the world, that we always keep in contact, so that's really special. My mother is, she's the typical Samoan, loud, speaks her mind.
Yeah, for e yei e kai mi fa pe nga e so lai a fa ya ku lo le ai a ye kam fa lo le fa excuse o ko ki no wa ka fa la o e ka o mai nga ke ni ya po ai ya a wa ma lo a e sa ka mi nga o le ba be ao.
You got to have that balance in life, you know. You just can't be just netball, netball, netball all the time.
But e limit le kai mi fa ya ko ye o ye.
Your limit is like once a month. My ideal man would be, I would imagine he'd be taller than me. But I know that there aren't a lot of men out there who are taller than me in New Zealand, so I'd have to go overseas.
Na oni wa faiso ko rua se ia kolo ko sfulu anga ilunga ia nga ngai fofua le skula nga papenga ke uma ko inga ka komo ki.
I was looking at that guy, so. My mother's beautiful, the best, the best mother I could ever ask for. My dad's just a big teddy bear, he's pretty cool.
We're both proud of her, what she's achieved, especially lifting, you know, our family.
Good work, Mum. It's that time again, folks. Polyscopes. Man, these things remind me of when I used to go to bingo with Mum. You just never know what you're gonna get.
Hey, Balongo, your weekly polyscope. Bingo! You gotta save your baby mama drama. What you wanna take her to the club for and be like that, eh? Get all trippy like that. Next minute, nobody wanna dance with you. Virgo, stop it now. Save it for later. You need to go somewhere. Virgo, just take it away, okay? Take it away. Take it away, Virgo.
What's your flavor? Go and get your equal gears, because later on, we turn up the heat on fresh flavors.
I'll be showing you how to make the best chicken chop suey.